Welcome to Honest Tutorials. This is Andy, and I am trying micro Kubernetes. It's actually my first time trying micro Kubernetes. It's not my first time in Kubernetes, but it's been a long time since I've used Kubernetes before. So in previous episode, I've managed to access the Kubernetes dashboard here. And it requires a bit of port forwarding, but it's working now and happy. So let's see if I can deploy an application. And in this case, I want to try how to deploy WordPress. Okay. And actually, there is stateless application here. So there are tutorials on the website. I think that a lot of people are familiar with WordPress, so let's try this one. Okay. So we need to create persistent volume claims and persistent volumes, create customization.yaml, then apply the customization and then clean up. Okay. So it says that we can use Minikube or the other ones. I will use micro Kubernetes here. Okay, so if we don't use a persistent volume, then that means every time the pod restarts, the data will be gone. But in this case, the data should be still there. Okay. So let's see. First, let's use, let's try to have this one. Okay, I'm going to use this. Let me use Visual Studio Code. So, workspace, and that means I can get this file. Okay, create a new file, and the password is your password. Okay, no problem. Save customization.yaml. Okay, and then let's go to the next step. Add resource configs for MySQL and WordPress. Okay, let's do this. Increase the font size so you can see more clearly. Okay. So let's check out what this deployment is about. Okay. Okay. Should be something like this. Okay. So we have a service here. It's the WordPress, and it exposes port 3306 for the WordPress MySQL. And then there is a persistent volume claim here, 20 gigabytes. Okay. And then there's a deployment. And we have a deployment of MySQL 5.6 here in the environment. Is from a secret key, and the secret key is from here. As you can see, the name is MySQL-pass. This is also MySQL-pass. And port 3306 and this one. So this is just for the MySQL, no WordPress yet. Okay, so it will expose the WordPress service at this port. Okay, it's nice. And let's see what should we do next. And after that, we have the deployment for WordPress itself. Okay. Let's create a file for the WordPress deployment. Okay, and I have to delete this file name. Okay, and then we have a service at port 80. Type is load balancer. And then we have a persistent phone claim for the WordPress, 20 gigabytes also. And then we have a deployment using an image of WordPress 4.8. Okay. Nice. Let's go back to the tutorial and okay. So we can download or I just did a copy paste of this before. And then I can add this to the customization.yaml file. Okay. Okay, let's try this one. Resources. Okay. So I've added that to my customization.yaml. And then let's apply this. Okay, so these are all the resources that is needed. We have the secret generator, and then we also have the two resources, MySQL and WordPress. So let's see if this is working. Now I should be able to do kubectl. Yeah, I need to add micro KNS. Apply, okay. And then wait, unable to find one of customization.yaml. Okay, so it seems that there is a problem here because the micro Kubernetes is actually running in a VM, and I'm trying to run this from the host, and it's trying to find these YAML files in the VM. So this is not working. So I guess I have to do this like almost manually. Okay. Let's just do this one by one. Or maybe I can try to. Let's try this one first. Apply using file customization.yaml. Okay, doesn't exist. That's weird. I comment this. Okay. It's definitely this file is there, right? Yeah. Okay. So something is wrong here. Let me try to find why this is the case. that I am not able to find why. By going into the VM, and I'll create the YAML file there. That's weird. Well, it's only one line. This is weird. Okay. For some reason it's not able to copy paste everything. Okay, let me try with a different shell. Still not working. Not sure why this is happening. Okay, let me try with the regular command prompt. This should work. And then I need another for the MySQL deployment. And I need another one for the WordPress deployment. Okay. So as you can see, this is a honest tutorial. It's not working. I tell you that it's not working. I don't know yet how is the best way to solve this, but I'm gonna find out. Okay, so let's move on and continue. I think I should have a better, bigger font here so you can see what's going on. Okay, then I should be able to do okay, so it is created now. So let me go back and try to see whether the secrets are there. Let's try. Or maybe I just use the Explorer shell now that it's I've finished applying this. Can do get secrets. And okay, so I have this MySQL pass. And let's see if I can get the password same as before. Is still provisioning. Okay, no connection. Oh, sorry, I have to do this. So the password is 13 bytes. And then maybe I need to know this dashboard. Oh, I need the token again. Let me grab the token. Okay, so now as you can see in the dashboard, I have several pods deployments. Okay, it's not working. This WordPress MySQL still unavailable. Let's see. Okay, so waiting for container. Okay, the service is running. This is just like the opening of the port, but the pods himself is still pending for already 2 minutes now. And we have a persistent volume. Okay, storage is 20 gigabytes. And okay, it's still pending. Okay, persistent volume claim not found. Yeah, okay, I think it's running now. Okay, the WordPress MySQL is running. Okay, seems good. And the deployment is running. Okay, so all pods is now running after about 2 minutes. Okay, based on the dashboard. So this is nice, yeah, this is nice. And then we can also use the command line to get this. Okay, so we have two persistent volume claims, and actually you can also see it using the dashboard. Okay, this is the WordPress PV, and this is the MySQL PV. And we can also see that they are running. And both are running, as we can also see from the dashboard. And we can also get the services. Okay, so let's see the WordPress service here. Okay, now okay, we can get the URL of the WordPress. Okay, this is using Minikube. I'm not sure if it's supported in MicroKS, but let's try. Let me see if we have other ways to use it. Actually, we have a cluster info actually that we can use by doing this. Okay, so okay, problem with this there doesn't seem to be a proxy for the WordPress one, but I should be able to connect to the WordPress by using port 80, but I have to do port forwarding. Okay, this is because this is the cluster IP. Let me try first. Let me try how we can just access it from here. Okay, it's not working. So I guess that we have to do some port forwarding. forward. I think this is the same way that we have to do, like kubectl forward and service WordPress, I guess, and see if I can do this. Okay, and let's see if I can now access this from 1080. Well, it's still not working. Oh, not localhost. I should use the IP address of the Microcat SVN. Okay, as you can see, I've now deployed WordPress here. So let's check out site title on this tutorial, handyaround.com, username handy, password. My email. Okay. And install WordPress. Okay. So seems to be working. And I can also, I want to find out if I get logs here. Kubectl logs in F WordPress. I have the logs of the WordPress here. Now I can log in, MD, and then the password. Okay. So I can log into WordPress. Very nice. This is using Kubernetes. So one that we need to try is what happens if the WordPress is stopped, if the pod is stopped, something goes wrong. Okay, so is it still possible to bring it back? Okay, so let me see. So what happens if I delete this pod? MySQL pod. Okay. So when I delete these pods, then because the deployment here has a replica set of one, okay, and that means that Kubernetes will create another pod to replace the killed pod. So we can see here that, okay, so I have more new pods. Let me try to check the logs. Okay, and let me see if I can still able to. Okay, it's not working. It's probably because not working because I have to re-port forward this. Okay, so I can still log in, and the site, the database is still there.
Okay.
So thank you very much for joining me on a tutorial on micro Kubernetes, and I've demonstrated you on how to deploy WordPress with persistent volume claim and also MySQL. And okay, so and now I should be able to destroy this. Then it's gone. No more WordPress. Let's see on the dashboard. Yeah, it's waiting and it's getting deleted. It's very nice. Okay, see you later on another Anas tutorial by Handy Rawan. Thank you.